It's Tuesday, the 20th of December, 2016. Good morning and welcome to another United Kingdom Talk, boys and girls. Yet another, look, little Christmassy type jumper on. These jumpers, actually, I kind of buy one or two a year. So I should have one, hopefully, for every day. These are about, this one, I think this one's about 2 years old. It's nice, isn't it? This is actually a 3D jumper, as purchased from Primark for about 20 quid. Look. But he's got a little bubble here, an actual hat there, or a scarf, which I suppose I could take out and use if I got a little cold nose or neck or something like that, I could put them on. So, yes, we're carrying on with the Christmas jumpers, boys and girls. What a lovely, lovely, lovely night it was at the karaoke last night at Central Station. Very busy. And to add to the bonus, the traffic wasn't bad. How weird is that? Now, I was expecting really bad traffic last night, and I actually left here at about 5:10 in the afternoon. Well, I got there at 7:15, so that's not bad at all. An hour and a half, hour and 40 minutes, I'm afraid, you know, is quite normal. When I've been doing 2 hours to get to work, an hour and 40 minutes doesn't sound too bad. I know it's only 20 minutes, but it really does make all the difference. So I got set up. And in the end, we started early. You know, I don't see the point in hanging around until your time. If you're set up and there are people in there ready to sing, you might as well start, mightn't you? You know, I know there's some people, no, I'm not paid till 8 o'clock. I ain't starting till 8 o'clock. Well, it's up to you, isn't it? I don't see the point of that at all. You might as well start, unless, of course, you're having something to eat. But I don't need to have anything to eat, because the lovely Maureen brought me in, as always, a little packed lunch of lettuce, little cherry tomatoes, bit of cheese, bar of chocolate, bag of crisps, and a very tasty jacket potato wrapped in foil. And what was the other thing? And a packet of something. And a satsuma. Oh, yes, a satsuma. Very, very nice satsumas, except the one with pips. The only thing is with satsumas, there might be clementines. I don't know which is which. Is it one? Is it that one has always got pips in it and the other has only sometimes? Because you don't expect satsumas to have pips in, do you? And you're like, oh, there's blooming pip in it. I hate that. Pips, dear. We don't do pips or seeds or things like that. So great night. Lots of Christmas songs being sung last night. Wendy last night was asking me how was my tummy. Actually, it's not bad at all, Wendy. It's doing quite well. Even the discomfort I kept getting on my side, that's hardly happening at all now. Just very occasionally, there's a bit of a discomfort, but nothing like what it was like. So I have a feeling this is now starting to sort itself out. Do you remember I had bad feet for 2 years? I had this, what I thought was a lump in there for about 6 to 9 months. And it's true what they say, you know, as you get older, things do seem to take a very long time to sort themselves out. You know, elderly people sort of in their 80s, I suppose, when they break a bone, I mean, it takes forever to get ready, to get sorted, doesn't it? So, feeling much better. Ronnie, my mate Ronnie, says that the discomfort in my side, he thinks I've got a parasitic twin inside me, you know, with real hair and teeth. And it's biting into my side, trying to get out. I mean, I could be laying on the bed one day on my lovely John Lewis downfield mattress topper, which I am so comfortable. It's even more comfortable than the other one. It's so comfortable. I could be laying there one day on my bed, you know, like that. I like to lay flat out like that just before I go to sleep. And I could suddenly get a bit of a stomach. And my parasitic twin with real hair and teeth could suddenly burst out of my stomach, like on the film Alien. Although I doubt very much it will be as ugly as that. What an ugly thing that was, weren't it? Imagine having something as ugly as that growing inside you, dear. Oh, my word. No, I think it would be a good-looking parasitic twin with real hair and teeth. Yes. So it could be that what's biting its way to get out there, OK? Now, I've seen another news story, I think, yesterday. Was it in the Daily Mail or somewhere like that? I can't remember. About this woman taking someone to court because she got touched. Oh, God's sake, another one. Yeah. Someone's touched her. Not necessarily, you know, there. Not necessarily there, but she was touched and she feels offended. Now, I just want to point out, I want to say this for the whole world to know, okay, boys and girls? If you see me out walking somewhere, whether I'm at work, you know, walking around with my microphone, or in the supermarket, in Waitrose, or anywhere like that, if you see me walking around and you want to have a bit of a feel, I want you to do it, okay? I will not be offended. I will not take you to court. There won't be anything like that. If you want to touch me, I will not be offended. I want you to just go ahead and do it. And you don't even have to do it, you know, like I do notice. I do notice occasionally, sometimes in the supermarket, you know, I might be leaning over, getting another bag of decaffeinated tea bags. Or perhaps bending over the fridge and getting some of my cart d'or ice cream out. And I have sometimes, oh, did someone just brush past me then? I thought to myself, you know, I don't want you to think that you've got to hide it, okay? Just, you know, make a point of having a little touch or even a grab. If you want to have a little squeeze of my bum as you're walking past, I want you to do it. I want the world to have the fun that it used to have for years and years and years without so many damn people. I'm so offended. Oh, get a life, will you, for God's sake. So if you see me walking around, I want you to touch me, boys. No holds barred. No holds barred. Touch anything that you want to as I'm walking. Now, don't start squeezing so it hurts. I will object if you hurt me. Can you hear Big Ben? Oh, there's a story about that. Just a moment. Listen. Can you hear it? It's my own personal Big Ben here in the Mirrorball Studios. Yes, so just back to the touch. And yeah, so if you see me walking around, you want to have a little touch or a squeeze, feel free to do that, okay? No problem whatsoever. I'm not going to take you to court. You won't be sued. There'll be nothing like that. There'll be no story in the Daily Mail. Oh, someone touched me. I'm really offended. No, not having anything like that. You go ahead and touch me as much as you want and then go home feeling happy. Yes. And I will too. I will feel privileged to think that you touched me. I will feel privileged to think that you took the time and trouble to have a little touch on me, yes. Now, Big Ben. So you just heard my own personal Big Ben here in the Mirrorball Studio with Moving Pendulum. Now, eagle-eyed Matt Martens in Canada, where it's very, very cold. Woo! Don't go to Canada in the winter. Oh, my God. Things drop off. People get off the plane and an ear falls off that it's so cold. It really does. Do not go to Canada in the winter. Well, Matt Martens pointed out kindly for me yesterday while he was watching this on his large screened television. Am I being watched today on another large screen, large screen television, Matt Martens. Who else watches this programme on a large screen television? Don't you find that a bit scary? Oh, it's not Halloween. I keep thinking it's Halloween. I don't know why. Who else watches it? Does anyone else watch this on a large screen telly? There's a question for you. Matt Martin pointed out that my pendulum was not swinging. It had stopped. And apparently it had been like that for a few days. I didn't even notice. So look, once again, the pendulum is in full motion, swinging forwards. And backwards, and forwards, and backwards. Thank you very much, Matt Martin, for pointing it out to me. Boys and girls, if you ever find something wrong here in the Mirrorball Studio, don't be afraid to point it out. Don't think, oh, I better not say anything. You might be offended. Okay, feel free to like, for example, the Christmas star that I keep forgetting to turn on. Bing! There it is. I keep forgetting to turn it on. Sorry about that. Yes, if there's something wrong here behind me, do let me know, because I don't always notice. We now have a poinsettia in the studio, as provided by the lovely Ray Reynolds. Thank you very much, Ray Reynolds, for my poinsettia. He now is the official provider of poinsettias to United Kingdom Talk around the Christmas period. Thank you very much, Ray Reynolds. That's the second one he's bought me. How kind, how kind. Now, Big Ben. Big Ben is to close its doors to visitors for a 3-year renovation project. I could have a renovation project on my face, I think. What do you reckon, eh? A little bit here, a little bit there, a little injection here. No, we're not having any of that, thank you very much. The work, which will begin early in next year. This is from the BBC website. BBC.co.uk. I'm still waiting for the phone call from the BBC. Oh, hello. Oh, hello, is that Chris? Hello, is that Chris Sheridan? Oh, yes, hello, who's that?
Oh, hello, it's me from BBC One, Colour. We wondered if you'd like to come do your chat show, Late Night Daily, here on BBC One.
Yes, well, I would like to do that very much. Thank you very much.
All right, if you'd like to come into the studio and we can have a little chat about it. Hey, yes, hi.
I'm still waiting for that phone call from BBC One Colour to ask me to go in and do a little chat or a quiz. I think I'd be quite good at quiz shows, yes. Quiz shows. Some of them are that what's his name? Ben someone or other. Ben Shepherd. It's a bit smart. It's a bit fake. I'm sorry. It's a bit fake. There's nothing flowing. I don't think anything comes out of his mouth naturally. He's reading it all off an autocorrect. Not like the great Bob Monkhouse. Oh, yes. From the golden shot. Up a bit. This. Left a bit. Right a bit. Fire. This is your golden day. And, of course, Bob's Full House. And, of course, Celebrity Squares. Do you remember Celebrity Squares? He's done them all. The great Bob Monkhouse. I don't believe for one moment he was reading from a script. No. Ben Shepherd, and to be fair, he's not the only one. Clearly, you know, you see them with that fake smile, and it is fake. It is so fake, that fake smile. And they're reading it all off a thing. Because if you look carefully, you can see their eyes moving like that as they're reading across the lines. Can you see my eyes read it moving like that? No, because it's all coming out. It just comes out. The rubbish that comes out of my mouth is all natural and unscripted. Thank you. Can we get back to the story, please? The work on Big Ben will begin early in the new year and will cost £29 million and involve repairs to the clock's hands, mechanism and pendulum. Well, I mean, all I did was shake the clock. Is it not as easy as that to get your pendulum going again? It might be. The Big Ben bell. Dun, 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 dun. The Big Ben bell is the one that goes dun, dun. The Big Ben bell, after which the Palace of Westminster's Elizabeth Tower is more commonly known, will fall silent to allow the work to take place. Oh, my God. It's going to fall silent. I just want to point out that I am not going to fall silent next year. I am absolutely not. No. Not for at least 200 years will I fall silent. Thank you. It will be the first time Big Ben has been silent since 2007. Parliamentary officials said the mechanism of the clock was in a chronic state, like me, dear. I'm in a chronic state. We're all in a chronic state, with fears it may fail if work is not carried out urgently. There were also concerns that the fabric of the tower itself is reaching an acute condition. Oh, my God, don't say the whole thing's going to topple over, dear. Not as I'm going round it. Oh, mind you, it won't be such a bad thing. You could actually, if you wait until Big Ben topples over, you could actually, and you could just quickly pick up a piece of Big Ben and take it home. And in your house, the Americans would buy this, you know. They would absolutely buy something like this. You could actually own a piece of Big Ben. How fabulous would that be? So, not such a bad thing. It'd be toppled over, get a new one built. A lift is being installed as well. It's more than 30 years since the last significant conservation work took place on Big Ben. So there we are. Clock faces will be covered, although at least one will remain visible at any time, and the bells toll for important events such as New Year's Eve and Remembrance Day. So there we are. We're not going to be able to go up Big Ben. I've always wanted to go up Big Ben, but it looks like I'm going to have to wait 3 years, and then there's going to be a lift. Oh, that would be so much easier. So I'll be 53, I'll be 56 by the time they reopen Big Ben again. And I would like to go up there and go up the stairs or the lift and have a look through the top. Although I am afraid of heights. I don't like heights. No, no, you won't catch me going up in one of those blooming... worst thing ever. I went on the London Eye. Oh, and the door closed and I started having an asthma attack. And I sat down rigid to that seat and I did not get up until the thing came back round again. Because once the door's closed, that's it. The point of no return. You can't say, could you open the doors? I think, no, too late. They're closed, mate. You're not getting off now until the whole thing's gone round again. Oh, I didn't like that. London Eye. So thank you very much to Johnny Key, who sent me in this. Of course, boys and girls, as Big Ben is going to be out of order and you're not going to be able to hear the bells, perhaps I should arrange tours here to the United Kingdom Talk Studios for you to come and sit here and listen to my very own mini Big Ben here in the studios of United Kingdom Talk. £25 a visit, I think, is very, very fair. £35 with a colour picture and a signed autograph. £45 if you also want a cup of tea with that as well. Yes, that could be a new little business for my sister. She could be downstairs doing the tea while you're up here listening to the dulcet tones of my own personal mini Big Ben. Ding, 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 ding. Here in the United Kingdom Talk Studios. I like the sound of that. Johnny Key's been sending us in some news stories again. Thank you very much, Johnny Key, who also sent me in a little birthday card. Oh, just a second. Now, I must read this for you. This is from Angela Washington. I did see a little at my very, very good friend in the United States of America, one of our Barry Manilow girls. I think she's met him twice on the Platinum Barry Manilow charity. By the way, that wasn't my bum I was scratching. And I've got my foot on my chair. My heel is very itchy at the moment. I wonder if there's anything on it. Let me have a look. Let me see if there is some scum or something on the bottom of my foot. Well, I can't see anything on it. Look, just a moment. Is there anything on the bottom of that foot there? Can you see anything? No, there isn't. My heel keeps getting itchy at the moment. I don't know why that is. Anyway. Yes, Angela Washington, who's met Barry twice now. One of her statuses this morning, she was watching QVC. QVC. That's the really old jingle. And something someone said on QVC this morning, and I quote, "No one is allergic to diamonds." The crap that they come out with on there. No one is allergic to diamonds. As heard on QVC this morning. Have you ever heard them trying to sell stuff? Oh, look, here is this beautiful... Actually, one of my friends, Michael Dalton, he does some radio in Australia. He did one of the shopping channels here. Now, it I think it was called Bid Up TV, where you bid. Not quite sure how it works. I never bought anything. But one of the things he had to sell were double electrical sockets, the sort that go on the wall. And you literally have to talk crap until people start buying these things. You really, really need these sockets. Have a look around at your socket. I mean, maybe I could do that. Could I do that? Could I sell things? Could I sell sand to the Arabs or ice to the Icelandic people? Could I do that? Maybe I could. Look at this beautiful socket. Now, have a look around your house. Have a look at those old sockets on the wall. Don't you think it's about time they replace? And of course, as the older they get so much more dangerous. You could have a wire pop off there and you could touch the socket and be electrocuted. Anything could happen. What you need is these brand new sockets, a bargain at only $7.99. Look at the ease of which new plugs plug in. Have you got some old sockets there? And you think, oh, they're a little bit stiff. You're having trouble pushing that in, or even worse, having trouble pulling something out. Maybe you've plugged some things in there before and they don't work anymore. Well, what you need is these new electrical sockets, a bargain at only $7.99 each. Buy them now. Maybe I should apply to be on one of those shopping channels. What do you reckon? Should I do that? I wouldn't be any good at fashion, though, would I, as you can see? Anyway, oh, my God, look at the time. 19 minutes I've been chatting for. Don't it go quick when you're enjoying yourself? I've got some cards. Here's my Christmas card from Johnny Key. Look at this. Oh, fabulous. And Johnny says, to Chris, wishing you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Keep the Union flag flying for us in 2017. Of course, it's up there on a little mug. It's over there on a little light. Never, ever be afraid to fly the Union flag. This is not a racist symbol. This is the flag of the United Kingdom. Never, ever be afraid to fly. And it does go up one way. It's either that way or that. I'm not quite sure what way. But there is believe it or not, there is actually an incorrect way of flying it, okay? It's either that way or that way. I can't remember which way it is now. So thank you very much for the news stories and the card there, John. I've got lots more cards here, which I'll show you over the next few days. Let's do today's birthdays, and then we'll go downstairs and do a Christmas carol. Oh, yes. Happy birthday today to my dear, dear cousin's wife, Jo Ryan, in Australia. Happy birthday, Jo. Looking very nice in that picture. Happy birthday, Jo. All right, darling. Happy birthday today to Gillian Corne, who is the daughter of a very, very dear lady who's no longer with us, Gwen. Happy birthday, Gillian. All right, my darling. Hope you have a nice day. Alison Johnson today is 46-year-old. And Gloria Gervasoni. I hope I've got your name right there. Now, I met Gloria when I was on Norfolk Island, which is in the South Pacific. It's kind of in between Australia and New Zealand a number of years ago, and she was doing some radio stuff. I don't know if she still does radio stuff over there, but it's her birthday as well today. Happy birthday, Gloria. Here comes the song. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Jo, Gillian, Alison and Gloria. Happy birthday to you. Have a wonderful day. All right, all ladies today, have a wonderful day today, ladies. Let's go downstairs and play you our daily Christmas carol on the organ. All right. And today's Christmas carol I have selected from you is The First Noel. Three verses for you, okay? Ready? Thank you. that one. That's all from me today, boys and girls. Very excited tonight to be meeting up with lots of friends. We're going to Pizza Hut or Pizza Express on the Charing Cross Road tonight with Matt and lots of my friends down there. Apart from that, have a lovely Tuesday and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.